Hi, my name's Karen Johns, and currently I am the lead simulation trainer over at University Hospitals Foundation Trust. After I qualified, after I got my degree, if you like, I was already doing 2 days simulation secondment within my clinical skills role over at University Hospitals Birmingham. And that lasted for about 6 months. And then in June this year, I was offered a full-time post as lead simulation trainer at University Hospitals Birmingham. I did the multidisciplinary simulation healthcare course in 2015. It was an inaugural course, so it was the first time that it had been set up. And it was with the Institute of Health Research at University of Birmingham. It was a three-module course broken down into adult learning theory in relation to simulation, human factors and simulation training, and then finally scenario development and running your own simulation scenarios. We had workshops, we did group work together, we had seminars, and we were also able to use a simulation suite over at University Hospitals Birmingham, which gave us some experience and exposure to running our own simulation with a group of students that were quite sim naive when we started. So that was a good experience. The fact that the course was actually being held at the University of Birmingham made it more convenient for me. I was already familiar with the university itself because I'd previously taught here as a clinical skills trainer. I knew that it was a reputable university, and the fact that the course was one that had only been provided in other institutions very rarely, there were only a couple of other institutions that actually provided this training. So it made sense for me to actually apply and see if I could get on the course initially. I was lucky enough to be given full funding for the course from the University Hospitals Birmingham Trust. So I felt very privileged, and I did a little bit of pressure to actually finishing the course and completing it properly as well. Prior to doing the multidisciplinary healthcare simulation course, I'd had some training in faculty development day that had been provided at the hospital where I worked. But that only just gave very basic kind of skills, and we were building on it, but as a trust, I think the education department within the trust felt that we needed to develop it more, make it more of a profession rather than just something that was an add-on to the job that I was already doing. The three modules that were involved in the course were adult learning theory, human factors, which obviously is one of the big things that healthcare in particular is looking at developing within the profession at the moment, and then actually designing and planning and running a simulation that you'd written for yourself. So the three elements actually then gave me more knowledge. Prior to doing this course, any training that I'd had previously had always been very dry, didn't seem appropriate for the job that I was doing. And it seemed that I was going on the course because it was almost a tick box exercise, whereas this course actually fulfilled everything that I wanted to do. It opened up a lot more avenues for me. It opened up my mind to how simulation could actually be used efficiently and effectively rather than just something that people did. And it's helped me develop now, and now with the role that I'm in the lead simulation trainer over at University Hospital, I'm actually developing faculty myself and developing courses for myself now. I think I enjoyed the fact that it was near to where I live. That's always a benefit. But I think meeting new people who were able to give me different aspects or their own ideas about simulation, I think you need to have that kind of openness about ideas and things like that, because it needs to be brought together the way we do simulation training across the board, and having other people's ideas and what they're doing themselves actually opened up a lot more ideas in my head about how I should be doing things once I took the job. My top tip would be, if you have an interest in simulation and you have an interest in healthcare, it would be the ideal course for you to do.